The Supreme Court statement that ran into 50 pages threatened the arrest of employees of X and ordered Brazil's telecommunications agency to block access to the platform. The reaction from Elon Musk, swift and scornful. Alessandra de Moraes is an evil dictator, cosplaying as a judge. And they're shutting down the number one source of truth in Brazil. But the judge, a formidable and powerful figure in Brazil, showed he's not afraid to wield the power given to him.
Liberdade de expressão não é liberdade de agressão. Liberdade de expressão não é liberdade de destruição da democracia, de destruição das instituições, de destruição da dignidade e da honra alheias. Liberdade de expressão não é liberdade de propagação de discursos de ódio e preconceituosos.
Firm support from the country's president, who took direct aim at Elon Musk.
Porque não é porque o cara tem muito dinheiro que o cara pode desrespeitar. Esse cidadão é um cidadão americano, ele não é um cidadão do mundo. Ele não pode ficar ofendendo os presidentes, ofendendo os deputados, ofendendo o Senado, ofendendo a Câmara, ofendendo a Suprema Corte. Ele pensa que é o quê?
Ever since he bought Twitter and renamed it X for $44 billion, Elon Musk has used the platform as a political tool, providing a space for people to say nearly anything they want. And many have, leading the Supreme Court to order X to take down accounts of supporters of former Brazilian President Jair Bolsonaro. They've been accused of peddling unsubstantiated claims that the 2022 election was lost due to fraud, a strategy that some believe should have consequences.
There has to be a responsibility that is placed on these social media sites to understand their power. They are directly speaking to millions and millions of people without any level of oversight or regulation. And that has to stop.
The Brazilian Supreme Court has also frozen the accounts of Musk's satellite company Starlink in an effort to claim the $4 million in fines already imposed. It's not clear just what the future holds for X in Brazil, but the longer the ban lasts, the more it will test Elon Musk's allegiance to his convictions at the expense of revenue and influence. Edmund Roy, SBS World News.